welcome to the Struggle for Justice show. I'm your host, Robert DeLillo. And today we're continuing the discussion on privatized prisons. And with me is Father Russ, and he is going to be presenting the American Federal, State, County, and Municipal Employees article that they have written, The Evidence is Clear, Crime Shouldn't Pay. And it's very thick. This will probably be a two-show presentation because the subject matter is so voluminous. And I will hand this over to Father Russ right now and get this on.
Yeah, well, I want to thank you. Which you may or may not know, we have a huge amount of listeners that follow us. AFSCME is my union that I retired from when I was a union organizer, and I still work with the American Federation of State, County, and Municipal Employees. So all you folks out there, all my union friends and everything, this report was done by our union, an extensive research situation that went over many, many years. And I'm going to read the introduction. It's really a formal paper, but it gets you into the whys we don't want privatization in prisons. Our guards union doesn't want it, and there's reasons, because they're professional people, that are trained in their jobs and stuff, and they feel that privatization does away with a lot of things, and they've done a major research program on it. So about a year and a half ago, AFSCME released a report entitled "Should Crime Pay?" And we posed the question because jurisdictions were increasingly turning over the entire operations of their correctional institution to for-profit companies. The report details some of the horrors that result from corporations profiting from the crimes of others. A year and a half later, more evidence has come to light showing that the Crime Should Pay program is valid in its research talked about the rapid increase in inmate population has caused a number of jurisdictions to come under court order to reduce overcrowding in jails and prison. And this goes back at the beginning of 1998, 44 of the 52 states and federal government correction system surveyed operated at or above capacity. In addition, 141 institutions were affected by court orders affecting population limits. In this frenzied climate, corporate America found a way to generate profits by building and operating correctional facilities. In other words, they took a situation, people were panicking, prisons were being overcrowded, stuffing a lot of people, and the state was trying to figure out ways to reduce their cost factor. And overcrowding is the most common reason cited by governments that turn to for-profit firms. Another rationale for privatizing prisons is the notion that privatization saves money, which is ridiculous. I mean, to think that private prison saves money. One thing, our correctional officers and our facilities and our unions are not there to generate a profit. They're there to serve the people of the Commonwealth or the state they're in. Private corporations are there to generate a profit for their shareholders and stuff like that. So it doesn't make any sense. There's no common sense to think that when you privatize a prison that you are going to reduce cost factors. And that's what this major study has shown. And this study was started in the 80s, okay? After more than a decade of experience with for-profit correction facilities in this country, there is no clear evidence that for-profit prisons save tax dollars. And there are a number of examples in which for-profit firms, they do sometimes initially look like they save money. because they get very favorable contracting terms that wind up costing the taxpayer more. Initially, they get limited taxes for property and stuff
no
like that.
Or no taxes at all.
Or no taxes at all.
They don't pay tax on the property that they get?
Initially, so it depends, okay? And then once they do, they bail out, okay? Because, that's one of They provide low-paying jobs and inadequate benefits for the employees, okay? So where you may have a correctional officer, okay, that's entry level maybe at $22,000 a year, you're going to have an entry level at $16,500 or $17,000 on an ill-trained individual. So it's going to look like you're going to save money, okay?
But you got to keep in perspective, too, that under the state has academies that the officers are trained.
Yeah, right. But
privatized prisons doesn't have that.
No, that's
so you have a security issue right off the top.
And they experience, well, they have a high turnover and turnover and understaffing. And again, as we said, they avoid paying income taxes, property taxes, so there's a lot of situations that appear like it's going to save you money, and in the end, it doesn't happen.
Yeah, but see, and you got to be careful, because another thing that happens, right, is these privatized prisons stick the government liability.
Oh, absolutely.
Which, you know, they do stuff where CCA got sued $51 or $52 million. They stood by and watched the prisoner die. Well, guess who gets hit with the liability?
The state does.
The taxpayers.
Yeah, that's right. And that's one of the things when we go through this whole report, which outlines all those things and outlines, in fact, they talk seriously about CCA, which is one of the biggest privatization firms in the country, okay, which is that is the Correctional Corporation of America, which started... They started doing these things in the mid '80s, okay. And actually, Kentucky became the first state to turn over complete operation of the prisons to a for-profit company. And it was.
But I want our listeners to understand something: that these privatized prisons are endangering public safety, and you really have to understand this. They are endangering public safety. One of the things about Ask Me was that we call for an end for profit privatized prisons. Our nation's correctional system should not answer, our nation's correction system should answer to the public,
right,
not to the corporate executives and shareholders. And this is the meat of the problem. This is the crux of the problem, is that security for profit margin.
Well, and what we want to do is we want to make sure our listeners know that you and I are not blowing smoke. I mean, when you look at this, the study that you have and that we have from AFSCME is huge. Okay, they studied corrections all over this country. Okay, and that's where they got their information, and they and the terms of happening where cost was cut on wages, where security was lax because they didn't spend the money on security, where ill-trained people caused damage and physical harm to prisoners. Okay, these are well documented incidences all over the country.
Ask Me did its homework.
And they all. Oh.